Good morning, students. In this program of Tarunotsav, we are going to see some amazing facts on mathematics. Mathematics is everywhere. Math is present in every moment of our life. When we walk, there is math. When we use our mobile phone, there is math. When you use our computer, there is mass. In our kitchen, when you make dosa, coffee, tea, etc., mass involved. So mass is everywhere. We can say there is no life without mathematics. So mathematics is one of the most important subjects in everyone's life. Most of us like this wonderful subject mathematics, but very few feel that it is difficult. But in reality, mathematics is not at all difficult, particularly when you learn it by understanding its base, then it becomes one of the easiest subjects. Here we are not going to learn any formula or to solve the problems. Instead, we are going to see some amazing facts in mathematics, particularly in the number theory. Now, we are going to see a number called Armstrong number. What is Armstrong number? Armstrong number is a number which is expressed as sum of cube of its digits. Here I have considered one number 153. Look at this number 153. 153 is expressed as 1 cube plus 5 cube plus 3 cube. 1 cube is 1, 5 cube is 125, 3 cube is 27. When you add this 1, 125 and 27, we will get 153. So 153 is one of the Armstrong numbers. So here there are some other Armstrong numbers are there. 370 is Armstrong number. 371 is also Armstrong number. 407 is also Armstrong number. So like this we can find many Armstrong numbers. Children, you know any other number? Let us know. Now, we will see the strange of the number 666. See, look at this number, what, 666. Some facts are there here. So 666 is expressed as 6 cube plus 6 cube plus 6 cube plus 6 plus 6 plus 6. See, what you can understand this. So 666 is expressed as sum of the cube of its digits plus sum of the digits. So this is one of the facts. Again, 666 is expressed as 2 square plus 3 square plus 5 square plus 7 square plus 11 square plus 13 square plus 17 square also. Now here, this is expressed as sum of the squares of the prime numbers up to 17. So these are all sub facts of the number 666. Now let us see one first number, first natural number 1. So you know 1 is a first natural number. Now we see some palindrome numbers formed by the number 1. Palindrome number. What is palindrome number? is a number, when we read both the sides, we will get the same number. So those numbers are called palindrome numbers. Now, these numbers are formed with the help of 1. How it is formed, let us see. Now, first, take 1. Multiply 1 by itself. So, 1 into 1, that is 1. That is, you read in both the side, here only one side, 1 only. Next, 11 into 11. Look at this, this number is 121. When you read 121 in both the side, it becomes 121 only. Then, when you multiply 111 by 111, you will get 12321. This is also a palindrome number. So, read either side, you will get the same. Now, again, you see, you are multiplying 111 into 111. You will get 1234321. This is also palindrome numbers. Like that, you can multiply any numbers with the digits 1 by the same number with the same digits, we'll get the palindrome number. So, okay. So you can see the pattern, it is look like a triangle. Next, magic of the number 9 is a very peculiar number. So we can see the magic of the number, that is a sequential inputs of the number 9. So see the pattern here. Here first multiply 9 with 9, that is 9 into 9 equal to 81. Okay, it's okay, no problem. Second stage, you see 99 into 99. Look at this, 9801. Just we can get this number with the help of the first number 81. So in front of 8, 9 is added. In front of 1, 0 is added. So okay. Next you see 999 into 999. Look at the number again. This can be obtained from the previous number again. Add one more 9 in front of that 9. That means 2 9s are added in front of 8 and 2 zeros are added in front of 1. Next, again you see 9999 into 9999. Again, in front of 8, 3 9s are added. In front of 1, 3 zeros are added. Like this. You see that, look at this last. So, last term, 9 9s, the number formed by 9 9s is multiplied by the same number formed by 9 9s. See, in this case, you see that in front of 8, in the solution, in the front of 8, 8 9s are taken, added, and in front of 1, 8 zeros are added. So, this is a sequential input of the number 9. So, look at that pattern. This pattern is also a beautiful triangle. Next, fact of number 2519. This is also a very good number. Just you can remember this number, 2519. Look at this number. When you divide this number by 2000, when you divide the number 2519 by 2, we will get the remainder 1. Here it is written mode. Mode is a concept for division which you will study in higher classes. But the mode is used here, but it is nothing but divided by. 2519 is divided by 2, the remainder which you get is 1. Similarly, 2519, when you divide it by 3, will get the remainder 2. When you divide it by 3, remainder 2. 2519, when you divide it by 4, the remainder is 3. Like that, when you divide 2519 by, for example, 7, the remainder will be 6. When you divide 2519 by 8, the remainder will be 7. When you divide the number 2519 by 10, the remainder is 9. So this is a beautiful number. When you divide the number 2519 by 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, we'll get the remainder 1 less than that number. So that means the number is not divisible by the number between 2 and 10. This is a very important fact of the number 2519. You know any other number like this? Please do comment. Now, the fact of pi. The pi you must have seen, you must have heard also, you must have used in your mathematics. So what is the value of pi? So pi, the value of pi is 22/7. In its decimal representation is up to 2 digit is 3.14. So the value of pi, that is irrational number, its value is 22/7 and its decimal value up to 2 digit is 3.14. Now write the 3.14 backwards, it spells pi. So this is a beauty of pi. Tasty, isn't it? Next, you see zero. Zero. See, any number can be represented in Roman letters. So 2 can be represented in Roman letters, 3 can be represented in Roman letters, even 100 can be represented in Roman letters. Like this, any number can be represented in Roman letters. But there is no representation for 0 in Roman. So 0 cannot be represented in the Roman letters. Have you found any new symbol for it? Okay, next. Birthday problem. Actually, this is a fact. Actually, this problem is related with permutation and combination. So you will be learning it in detail in higher class. So I'll read the problem. In a room of just 23 people. So that means there are 23 people in a room. There is a 50% chance that 2 people have the same birthday. So 23 people are in a room. Out of them, 50% chances that 2 people have the same day as birthday. In the same manner, in a room of 75 people, there is a 99% chances of 2 people have the same birthday. Like this, we can find out many things. Now, so how many from your class? Just think it and share your answer with your friends. Now, fun facts with a pack of cards. That's related with the playing cards. You must have seen the playing cards, or you must have played with the playing cards. Now, the pack of playing cards contain 52. When you shuffle a pack of 52 cards properly, chances are that the exact order has never been seen before in the history of universe. So when you see, when you shuffle the card properly, if you will never seen the same pattern again. This is a universal truth. So you must have played, but you may not notice this fact. So this is a universal fact that the same pattern you will never get at all. Now, Kapraykar's number, that is Kapraykar's constant. See, what is Kapraykar's constant? The number 6174 is called Kapraykar's number, that is Kapraykar's constant. Why it is called Kapraykar's constant? The process is given just to see. Choose a 4-digit number. The only condition is that it has at least two different digits. This is a condition. Choose any four digit numbers. See, arrange the digits of the four digit number in descending order and ascending order. Arrange the digits of the number in descending order and ascending order. Subtract the smaller number from the larger number. Subtract the smaller number from the larger number. We'll get the result. The result may be 6174. If the result is not 6174, then that number, arrange the digits in the ascending order as well as descending order. We'll get two numbers. Again, subtract the smaller number from the larger number. Repeat the process. Finally, you will end up at 6174. Finally, you will get the number 6174, which is known as Kapraykar's constant. If you then repeat the process with the 6174, you will just keep getting same again and again. If you continue the process with the number 6174, you will be getting the same 6174 again. That's why this number is a peculiar number. This number is called Kapraykar's constant. Now on Bessel. See, you are at a Poundain. There is a Poundain. You are at a Poundain. And you have with you 3-gallon jug and a 5-gallon jug. There are two jugs with you. One is of 3 gallons and another one is of 5 gallons. The jugs have no marking on the sides. How would you be able to measure out exactly 1 gallon of water? How would you be able to measure exactly 1 gallon of water with the help of the jug? There are two jugs. One is of 5 gallons measurement, another is of 3 gallons measurement. So we need 1 gallon of water. Using this, you need 1 gallon of water. How to measure? So think the solution. Think about the solution. Okay, let us see how it can be done. Solution is given. First, fill up the 3 gallon jug to the top and pour it into the 5 gallon jug. So remaining 2 gallon water free phase is there in 5 gallon jug. Now fill up the 3 gallon jug again and pour as much as you can into the 5 gallon jug. That is 3 minus 2, 1 gallon will be left out. 1 gallon of water left in the 3 gallon jug. So this 1 gallon of water, you pour it in the 1 gallon jug. So this 1 gallon of water we can get with the help of this process. So okay, next. Now you think how to get exactly 4 gallons of water with the same setup. With the help of the two jugs, one is of 3 gallons measurement, another is of 5 gallons measurement. Using these two jugs, how to measure 4 gallons of water? Please solve it and share the answer with your friends. Do you know any further facts like this, children? Thanks for watching this video. Now you must have understood that how amazing facts, funs, magic, etc. are hidden inside mathematics. Students, to enjoy much more funs like these, mathematics, you take mathematics as one of the optional subjects in your class 11th. Thank you. Thank you for watching.